Good morning, children. I hope all of you are keeping fine. Today, we are starting with the next lesson, the second lesson of Flamingo, Lost Spring. Lost Spring, written by Anise Jung. First of all, let us discuss about the author. Anise Jung was born in Rourkela in 1964. She spent her childhood and adolescence in Hyderabad. She received her education in Hyderabad and in the United States of America. She began her career as a writer in India. She has been an editor and columnist for major newspapers in India and abroad. She has authored many novels. Lost Spring is an excerpt from her book titled Lost Spring, Stories of a Stolen Childhood. In this, she analyzes the grinding poverty and traditions which condemns these children to a life of exploitation. So first of all, let us discuss why this title, The Lost Spring, has been given. Children, as you know, spring is associated with childhood. Just as spring is the season when flowers bloom. Similarly, childhood is the period when an individual blooms and grows. Anise Jung here presents the horrific truth about the life of children in India who are victims of child labor and are not allowed to grow and bloom freely. Their childhood is lost. This story deals with the deplorable condition of poor children who get forced to miss the simple, joyful moments of childhood because of their socioeconomic conditions. This is not only the reason, some other reasons are also there, like ignorance, illiteracy. These children are not given the opportunity of schooling and are compelled to start working early in life. The author Anise Jung strives hard to eliminate child labor through her book. She propagates the education of children and enforcement of strict laws against child labor by the government. The message of this chapter is to put an end to child exploitation and let all children enjoy their days of spring and joy. About the characters of this story, the first character is Sahib Alam, who is a rag picker. The irony lies in the meaning of his name. The meaning of his name is the Lord of the Universe. According to his name, he should be a king and enjoy all the luxuries of life. But unfortunately, he is a rag picker who moves here and there barefoot and who lacks all the basic necessities of life. Another character, Mukesh, who is a son of a bangle maker, and the family members, they have taken it as their destiny. Grandmother of Mukesh, she says, they are destined to work like this. It is their karam. Now let us proceed with the chapter. The very first incident which the writer has said about is about Sahib Alam. Sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. This part talks about the writer's impressions about the life of the unfortunate rag pickers. The rag pickers migrated from Dhaka and find a settlement in Simapuri. They end up losing their fields and homes due to a storm. They then came to the big city to find a living, but they are poor. The author watches Sahib, the rag picker, every morning, who is always scrounging for gold in her neighborhood. And the meaning of this garbage or gold is different to different people. Like elders, for them, it is the means of survival. And for children, it is something wrapped in wonder. Sometimes the children find a coin or two. These children, they are ambitious also. They also want to live the life full of basic necessities. But they are, that are unreachable to them, like shoes, education. They do have some dreams. Like Saheb, he is often seen watching the tennis player playing. He stands outside the fencing and would keep on watching. Afterwards, Saheb starts working at a tea stall where he earns 800 rupees, but he is not happy. Not only he earns 800 rupees, he earns 4 times meal also. But he is not at all happy because he has lost his freedom. When he was a rag picker, he was able to move wherever he wanted to. He was his own master. But now he has to work under the owner of the tea stall. Wherever and whatever he would ask him to do, that only he has to do. Next one is Mukesh, who is a bangle maker, son of a bangle maker. He wants to drive a car. He comes from the family of bangle makers and he lives in Firozabad. Firozabad is quite popular for its glass blowing industry. 20,000 children are a part of this business. And any law that forbids child labor is brutally ignored here. The working condition and environment and the living conditions are pathetic. Children live in dingy cells and work around hot furnaces that make them blind when they enter adulthood. Children, do you think these children, when they work in the glass factory, they are given protective gears? Not at all. They walk near the hot furnaces barefoot. Sometimes they handle the hot appliances bare hand. The care of their health is not taken. Not only this, the places where they live, that is also not appropriate. They are not well ventilated, they are not well lit. Whenever these people, they want to form any cooperative or association to uplift their standard, they are not able to do so. They are weighed down by debt. They cannot think or find any way to escape this trap. The politicians, policemen, middlemen, and bureaucrats obstruct their way of progress. Most women in such families think that this is their fate and just follow the tradition. But Mukesh is very different from the rest of the folks there. He has a dream of becoming a motor mechanic. And he says the garage is quite far away from his house. But he is so determined that he can walk up to that place and definitely he would learn that and he would become a mechanic. So this is a summary of the chapter. I would suggest you to go through the chapter to understand it in a better way. Here this chapter is given the in points in nutshell. Just go through it some word meanings are given. You may find some more words difficult. Consult the dictionary to get the meaning. For your comprehension, some question answers are given. Go through it. After that, some questions are given to you for self-assessment. Please write it down in your copy. I hope all of you must have enjoyed it. Just stay at home and stay safe. Thank you, children.